Hey there, Psych2Go family. Here we are with another video to help you understand everyday psychology better. How do you deal with certain emotions you don't quite know how to process? Do you repress what you're feeling because you're too afraid to admit it to yourself? Emotions serve to let you know how you're being affected by the things going on in your life and in yourself. They're neither positive nor negative, but simply act as signals to point you towards the right direction and help you make sense of what you're going through. And while it may be scary and uncomfortable at times, understanding your emotions can help you better understand yourself and your underlying wants, needs, and beliefs. Are you wondering if you're emotionally in tune with yourself? Well, here's a list of 10 emotions to help you get started. 1, happiness. So which emotion do you have the earliest memory of? One of the first core emotions you experience is happiness. When you're younger, happiness is often a feeling that comes from a sense of safety and security that your parents bring you. It arises from the knowledge that you are loved and taken care of. As you grow older, you might begin to associate it with feelings of contentment and emotional connection. Joy, pleasure, and satisfaction all exist to remind you of what it is that you value most. So think about the times when you feel happiest, and you'll come to realize what it is that you want most in life. 2, sadness. That emotion which follows the loss of something that was important to you. Sadness is a very complex and nuanced emotion. Having varying degrees and manifesting in a lot of different ways, its most important purpose is to help you process your feelings of grief and disappointment. Feeling sad allows you to take a step back and look at yourself and your situation to better understand what it is that's causing so much pain. It teaches you to be more introspective, resilient, and learn from your mistakes. 3. Anger. If you hear the phrases, clenched fists, tense muscles, and a flushed face, what emotions come to your mind? While it may not seem like it, anger can actually be a very good emotion to experience if you take the time to understand it more. You feel frustrated because there's something stopping you from getting what you want, so you lash out by breaking things or stomping your feet to make yourself feel less helpless against the situation. But anger is meant to do more than just beg to be unleashed. It forces you to act and fight against the problems you're facing. 4, anticipation. Do you remember that feeling just before an exam starts? In the most basic meaning of the word, anticipation refers to the psychological state of arousal that you experience when you're excited, anxious, or uncertain about what's to come. If you're feeling anxious about something, it's your mind's way of reminding you to plan ahead of time and better prepare yourself for the future. But if what you feel is more of a nervous excitement, then it means you're doing something that pushes you out of your comfort zone, and that's a good thing. 5, fear. Evolutionary psychology tells us that fear is the basic survival mechanism of our ancestors, meant to keep them safe from potential danger. It's why you have an innate fight or flight response that's triggered whenever you feel physically or emotionally threatened by something. But sometimes you feel fear towards things that aren't lethal, like failure, uncertainty, emotional vulnerability, and the loss of control. If you're not aware of your emotions, your fear can keep you from taking risks, challenging yourself, and going after what you want. 6, loneliness. Loneliness results when you feel isolated from those around you. Famous psychologist Abraham Maslow even posited that one of the most basic human needs is the need for belongingness, along with the psychological needs for shelter, food, and water. As a human being, you have a deep-seated need for social interaction. Loneliness is meant to signal to you that you need to reconnect with your loved ones and attend to relationships with those you care about. You can learn more about this by watching our upcoming video, 7 Reasons Why You Feel Lonely. 7, jealousy. Ever get that strange feeling of wanting what someone else has? You may feel envious of others when you perceive that they're more fortunate than you in some way, that they're happier, wealthier, smarter, or more successful. Jealousy gives way to insecurity and hurts your self-esteem because it makes you think that you aren't good enough to have everything you want. It's important for you to pay close attention to what sparks that feeling in you because it speaks volumes about what it is you feel is missing from your life. 8, disgust. What is the exact emotion you feel when a cockroach comes into your sight, causing you to shriek? Another emotion rooted in our evolution is that of disgust. You feel repulsed by things that you consider to be unclean or disease-ridden, like cockroaches, rats, waste, and rotten food. You also feel revolted by things that go against the most fundamental social norms, such as heinous crimes and certain sexual behaviors. A feeling of intense dislike and aversion. Disgust is an emotional response you feel towards something that is unhealthy for you. 9. Surprise. Surprise is something you feel when something unexpected happens to you or those around you. Shock and surprise can intensify whatever emotions you're feeling, like happiness, anger, and despair. When you feel surprised, you become more curious and alert because it forces you to change your perspective and adapt to new situations. And 10, trust. Why is trust on this list of emotions, you ask? Many would argue it's not so much an emotion as a choice. And while it's true that trust isn't as instinctive a feeling as these other basic emotions, it's still a feeling because sometimes you just feel like you can trust someone, even if you don't really know them that well yet. Trust is an emotion built on your experiences, and it's meant to remind you of both the good and bad that other people have done unto you so that you can better protect yourself against emotional pain. Oftentimes, trust and love go hand in hand. So when a loved one betrays you, they often lose not only your trust, but also your affection. In the end, the journey towards emotional self-discovery helps you have a better understanding of who you are. So take the time to listen to what your emotions are trying to tell you and work through all the things you're feeling. Emotional awareness will not only allow you better control over your moods, but also show you things about yourself that can help you live a more meaningful and emotionally fulfilling life. Were you able to relate to some of these points? Are you now able to understand your emotions more clearly? Do let us know in the comments below. Also, share this video with those you think might benefit from it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.